Hello student, I am Parvati Pawar, working as an assistant lecturer, and this learning online content has been brought to you by Vidya Jyoti University. Student, a topic will be discussed today, identification of equipment. As this topic is little big, we divide it into two parts. So this is the part one. In this part one, subtopics are light equipment, selection of kitchen equipments, hands tool used in kitchen, processing equipment. So this course is BWOC Hospitality and Catering Management. And semester is second semester. Subject with the code is Kitchen Management 2nd BVHCA 20119. Subjective. So student, the aim of this unit is to prepare you for working in a kitchen using the equipment and knives in a safe manner. You will learn how to use the various items of small kitchen equipment and utensils and how to clean and store them hygienically. You will be able to select the correct knife for the task, use it safely and hygienically, and will be able to sharpen and store the equipment correctly. Let's discuss about the introduction. Having the proper tools and equipment for a particular task may mean the difference between a job well done and one done carelessly, incorrectly, or even dangerously. This module introduces most of the tools and equipment typically used in professional bulk kitchen. So equipment used hotel catering can be divided broadly into heat producing equipment, cold producing equipment, processing equipment. This can be divided into heavy equipment, light equipment. So student, as earlier I discussed, this topic is big, so we divide it into two parts. So in this topic we are going to discuss about the light equipment. So part two we will be discuss about the heavy equipments. The type of kitchen equipments are food preparation equipment, cooking equipment, holding service and cleaning equipment, washing and storing equipment. Selection of kitchen equipments is important. In general, only commercial food service tools and equipment should be used in a professional kitchen. Household tool and appliances may not withstand and rigor of a professional kitchen. Look for tools that are well constructed. For example, joints should be well welded, not bonded with the solder. Handle should be comfortable with rounded border. Plastic and rubber parts should be seamless. Before purchasing or leasing any equipment, you should evaluate several factors. So some basic factor of selection of equipment, very important points. So we have to check first about the menu. Equipments also depends on the method of cooking. Example, for menu consisting of fried snacks will require a fryer. So then is the uses. Every equipment selected must be able to fulfill specific purpose, be it especially of producing, efficiency of producing, profitability of customer or customer satisfaction, then price. The investment in equipment has to be made carefully. It's essential to judge whether the new equipment is improving producing in both term of quality and quantity. Quantity and quality. Easy of installation, maintenance and operate. Very important point, because you have to know how to install, how to maintain and how to operate. Equipment must be user friendly, taking care of the exciting skills of the catering staff. The equipment should also be very easy to clean and maintain. Safety. It is extremely important to select equipment that is guaranteed for safety. While in operation and when not in use, guard and lock should be provided to avoid accident. About the appearance. So good looking equipment attract workers' attention and create a desire for using and caring for it. Source to supply. Equipment should be purchased from reputed suppliers so that it is backed by guarantee and after sales service and maintenance contract. Hand tools introduction. Hand tools are designed to aid in cutting, sharpening, moving or combining food. They have few, if any, moving parts. Knife discussed separately later. Are the most important hand tools. Other are metal or rubber spatula, spoons, whisk, tongs and specialized cutter. In addition to the items show here, many hand tools designed for specific tasks such as a pressing tortilla or pitting cherries are available. Strength, durability and safety are the watchword when selection head tools. Choose tools that can withstand that heavy use of professional kitchen and those that are easily clean. So knife are the most important item in your toolkit. With a sharp knife, the skilled chef can compromise a number of tasks more quickly and efficiently than any machine. Good quality knives are expensive but will last for many years with the proper care. Select easily sharp, well conducted knives that are comfortable and balanced in your hand. So knife construction and commonly used knife are discuss here. A good knife being with a single piece of metal stem but or best of all forged and tempered into a blade of this desired shape. So students, I love to discuss with you the metals generally used for knife blades. So it's a carbon steel, stainless steel, high carbon stainless steel and ceramic. For the carbon steel and alloy of carbon and iron, carbon steel is traditionally used for the blade because it's soft enough to be sharp easily. Then the stainless steel. Stainless steel will not rust or discolor and is extremely durable. So then high carbon stainless steel and alloy combine the best feature of carbon steel and stainless steel high. Carbon stainless steel is neither corrodes nor discolor and can be sharp almost as easily as a carbon steel. Then about the ceramic. Ceramic is now used to make a knife blade that are extremely sharp, very easy to clean, but is little expensive. So types of knife: French or chef knife, an all-purpose knife used for chopping, slicing, and mincing. It's a rigid 8 to 14 inches long blade, is wide at the heel and tapers to a point at the tip. Utility work and all-purpose knife used for cutting fruit and vegetable and carving poultry. Its rigid 6 to 18 inch long blade is sharp like a chef knife but narrow. So boning knife, a smaller knife with a thin blade used to separate meat from bone. The blade is usually 5 to 7 inches long and may be flexible or rigid. There is a paring knife. A short knife used for the detailed work of cutting fruit and vegetable, and rigid blade is from 2 to 4 inches long. There is a cleaver. So a knife with a long heavy rectangular blade used for chopping or cutting through bones. Then slicer. A knife with a long thin blade used primarily for slicing cooked meat. The tip may be round or pointed and the blade may be flexible or rigid. So the butcher knife, sometimes known as a scimitar because the rigid blade curves up in a 25 degree angle at the tip. It is used for fabric cutting raw meat and is available with a 6 to 14 inches blade. Oyster and clam knife, as a short rigid blade of the knife are used to open oyster and clam shell. The tip are blunt, only the clam knife has a sharp edge. So this is all about the knives types. So how to sharp a knife? So we are using for the sharpening knife, sharpening stone, also known as a whetstone, a flat brick of synthetic abrasive that is used to put an edge on a dull blade. Various grade size are available. The most particular sets including both core and fine grade stone. So then is a steel, a scored slightly abrasive steel rod used to hone on straightening a blade immediately after and between sharpening. Student, you can see in the second picture is a picture of steel rod. So let's discuss about the cookware. Cookware including the saute pan and stock pan used on the stove top as well as the roasting pan, hotel pan and specialty mold used inside the oven. Cookware should be selected for its size, shape, ability to conduct heat evenly and overall quality of construction. So student, meat and heat conducting. So cookware that fails to distribute heat evenly may cause hot spot that burn food. Because different metal conduct heat at different rates, the thicker layer of metal conduct heat more evenly than thinner ones. The most important consideration when choosing cookware are the type of and thickness, known as the use of the material used. No one cookware or material suit every process or need. However, always select the most appropriate material for the task at hand. Then is about the copper. Copper is excellent conductor. It heats rapidly and evenly and cools quickly. Indeed, unlike copper pots are unsurpassed for cooking sugar and fruit mixture, but copper cookware is extremely expensive. Aluminium. Aluminium is a metal used most commonly in commercial utensils. It is a lightweight and after copper conduct heat best. Aluminium is a soft metal through, so it should be treated with the care to avoid dents. Do not use aluminium container for storing or food for cooking acidic. Stainless steels. Although stainless steel conduct and retain heat poorly, it is a hard durable metal, particularly useful for holding food and for low temperature cookware, whereas hot spots scoring are not problem. Cast iron cookware distribute heat evenly and holds high temperature well. It is often used in grindless and large skills. Then glass. So glass retain heat well but conduct is poorly. It does not react with the food. Temperate glass is suitable for microwave cooking provided it does not have any metal band of description. Ceramic including earthware, porcelain and stoneware are used primarily for baking dishes, casserole and baking stone because they conduct heat uniformly and retain temperature well. Ceramic are non-reactive, inexpensive and generally suitable for use in micro oven, providing there is no metal in the gas. Then plastic. Plastic containers are frequently used in commercial kitchen for food storage or service, but they cannot be used for heating or cooking except in a microwave oven. So about the non-stick coating. So non-stick coating without affecting a metal's ability to conduct heat are polymer plastic, known as a polytrophenol. PTFE. So is a synthetic fluoropyrimina or tetrafluorina that has numerous applicants. The well-known brand name of PTEF base of formula is telephone by. Then PTEF is used as a non-stick coating for a pan and other cookware, and marketed under the trade name telephena and silvertine, may be applied to many type of cookware. It provides slippery non-reactive finish that prevent food from sticking and allow the use of less fat in cooking. About the common cookware. So common cookware pots are low ground vessels with straight side and loop handles, available in a range of size based on volume. They are used on the stove top, making stock or soup, or for boiling or simmering foods. Particular pans are round vessel with one long handle and straight or stop sides. They are usually smaller and shallower than pots. Pans are available in a range of chemistry and are used for generally stove top cooking, especially sauteing, frying or reducing liquid rapidly. So then is a wok, originally used to proper Asian food. Wok are now found in many professional kitchen. Their round bottom and curved side diffuse heat and make it easy to toss or stir content. Student, in second picture you can see, this a picture is for the wok. Then is a molds. The molds are available in several shape and size and are usually made from thin steel. Those are high sides, whether smooth or pattern, and more properly referred to as a cum molds. The hind side make it easier to remove the baked plate. Pate, terrin mold are traditionally lead earthware or enhanced cast iron container used for baking. There is a strainer and sieves. Strainers and sieves are used primarily to aerate and remove impurity from dry ingredients and drain or purely cooked food. Then is the skimmers and spiders. The skimmers and speeder both are, that skimmers and speeder are long handle tools used to remove food or impurity from liquid. The fat perfecting disk of a skimmer is used for skimming stock or removing food from soup or stocks. Then is about the food mill. Food mill, a food mill puree and strain food at the same time food is placed in the hopper and hand crank mechanism turn and a blade is in the topper hopper against a perforated disc, forcing the food through the disc. So let's discuss about the processing equipment. Processing equipment include both electric and non-electric mechanical device used to chop, puree, slice, grind or mix food. Before using any such equipment, be sure to review the operating procedure and ask for assistance if necessary. Slicer. Electric slicer is used to cut meat, bread, cheese or raw vegetable into uniform slice. It has a circular blade that rotates at high speed. Food is placed in a carriage and then pass manually or by an electric motor against the blade. Then is a mandolin. A mandolin is a manually operated slicer made of stainless steel with the adjustable. Slicer blade is also used to make a julienne and waffle skirt slices. Its narrow rectangular body sits on the wall counter at the 45 degree inch angle. Food chopper or buffalo chopper. Chopper is used to process moderate a large quantity of uniform size, such as a chopping onion or grinding bread or crumbs. The food is placed in a large bowl, rotating bin and woodware curved blade chopping. Food processor. A food processor has a motor housing with a removable bowl and shaped blade. It is used, for example, to puree cooked food, chop nuts, prepare compounded butter and emulsify sauce. Special disc can handle the slice, share or julienne food. Blender. Blender through similar is principle to a food processing. A blender has a tall, narrow food container and a four-pronged blade. It is a design and whirlpool action is better for processing liquid or liquid frying food quickly. A blender is used to prepare smooth drink, puree, soup and sauce, blend batter and chop ice. A variety of cutter mixture, VCM, operates like a very large powerful blender. A VCM is usually floor mounted and has a capacity of 15 to 80 quart. Then is an impression blender. Immersion blender, as well as its household counterpart called a hand blender or wand, is a long shell fitted with a rotating for a prone blade at the bottom. Operate by pressing a button in the handle. An immersion blender is used to puree a soft food, soup or sauce directly in the container in which it was prepared, eliminating the need to transfer the food from one container to another. Mixer. A vertical mixer is indispensable in the bake shop and most kitchen. The U-shaped arm hold a metal mixing bowl in place. The selective mixing attachment fit onto the rotating head. The three common mixing attachments are the whip, used for whipping egg or cream, the pedal, used for the general mixing, and the dough hook, used for the kneading breads. So most mixtures have several operating speeds. The juicer. Two types of juicer are available. Remains are extractor. Ramiri, also known as a citrus juice, remove juice from citrus fruit. Disclaimer. This is from internal circulum only. Circulation only can be manual or electric. Manual use a lever arm to squeeze the fruit with the increased pressure. They are most often used to prepare a small tomb. So student, this all topic conclusion are identify the different type of equipment and usage, state factor in selected equipment and utensil for use, state how to use equipment and utensil correctly and safely, state the importance of correct and safe use of knife and cutting equipment, describe how to clean, maintain and store knife and cutting equipments. And this all online content sources are textbook of food production BTK Vikas Singh, EPG Pathshala, food production operation Parvinder Bali, Frank Bros, New Delhi, 2019. Agarwal, DK Kitchen Equipment and Design, Aman Publication, New Delhi. Please free to ask question. Our email ID is hod.hcmi@gmail.com and our contact number is 9815353055. Keep learning and warm thank you from Vidya Jyoti University. Student, I hope you enjoy this session. Thank you very much.